What's the strangest question you've ever been asked at a job interview? The job entailed a lot of filing of papers, so I got asked how do you best file things in folders alphabetically? I was like with a folder for each letter, and then put the folders in alphabetical order. She said good, good, and jotted down some notes. Overqualified. Weird series of questions. Interviewer picks up phone. What's your wife's number? Me. She's in the US and it's 2 a.m. there. Why would you want to call my wife? Interviewer. Is your mother also in the US? Me. Yes. Why? Interviewer. Well, say I would call your wife a mother. What would they say is your most annoying habit? Giving out their numbers to buttholes with boundary issues. Interviewer. I see you graduated from school in 2013. Did you know Amaze? Jane Doe? Me. Oh yeah, I know her. She was in my first year classes. Interviewer. Ms. Doe interviewed yesterday. Why should we hire you over her? I basically responded with you should hire us both, ideally. Then I said why I'd be good for the job overall. Neither of us got the job. I was interviewing a potential employee with my supervisor and the last question he asked her was how are you with dealing with stupid people. It was completely out of left field and informal based on the questions we were previously asking. You could tell the question through her but she answered. And she ended up getting the job. I'd say I've done a pretty good job so far in this interview. If you were a tree, what kind of tree would you be? I was interviewing for an analyst position so I went for a decision tree, got the job. Whichever tree is made of morning wood. Wasn't a question, just funny weird. I was in high school looking for a part-time job, so I went to a local Chinese restaurant and asked for an application. Their response, what's that? I said I would like to work for them. So the person behind the counter told me to hold on for a minute, went into the kitchen to talk to the owner, and came back out to hand me a pen and a sticky note. He told me to write down some information. I write my name and phone number and ask if that's enough and he says that it is. So, I get a call over the weekend asking me to come in Monday after school. I thought, cool, got an interview. I show up and they tell me to pull my car around back. When I do, they come out of the restaurant with a bag of food and a GPS and say, here, go deliver this. Needless to say, I got the job and worked for them for the next 6.5 years. A lot of mom and pop places don't give a frick. They just want help from someone who isn't a druggie or a weirdo. My friend had an interview at Panera which ended up being 3 separate interviews and she said they made them sit in a circle and talk about the texture of bread and how it made them feel. If you were a brick in a wall, which one would you be? I'm sorry, I didn't know I was interviewing with Pink Floyd. One in the middle, dependent on those below and supportive of those above. This was during a mock interview while I was in college. The professor had her husband come in and we had to go in, one by one, and do an interview. Just like in real life. Well, everyone is going in and coming out smiling. Not taking too long, so I thought it would be a cakewalk. My turn is next. I go in and everything is going smoothly. He takes a look at my resume and sees that I was in the military. He asks, tell me about your time in the military. So I tell him what I did. That I worked with a variety of different people from different backgrounds, with different views on life and opinions, and that I supervised people, etc. He says okay, good, and continues with the interview. Asks a few more questions, then says tell me about your time in the military. I figured maybe he didn't realize he already asked me that, or maybe it was a test, so I repeated what I said. He starts turning slowly in his chair, looking at the ceiling and says again, tell me about your time in the military. I just looked at him. He stopped spinning in his chair and looked at me. After about 20 seconds, he says okay, we're done here. I gotta be. Saw a meme about this recently that made me chuckle. Interviewer, tell me what you did in the military. Guy, I'd rather not, I kind of need this job. You want a beer, no lie. Just like that. I hesitated because I was not expecting that. But he opened the fridge and it was filled with beer, half Budweiser, half Coors Light. I passed on the beer, still have the job. You obviously have a great resume. Why haven't you gotten another offer yet? Is something wrong with you? People keep asking me stupid freaking questions. I was being interviewed by a certain cell phone service provider. The interview was going great. The manager was really nice and charismatic, but the last question really stuck out to me. If this company implemented a policy that you thought was morally wrong, would you still follow said policy? I answered no, and I said that if I thought the policy was wrong on a moral level, that I would likely quit the job. That's when I was dismissed from the interview. Needless to say, I don't use that provider anymore. Completely technical interview. Then at the end of the interview, they asked me if I was a fruit or a vegetable, what would I be and why. I laughed and asked them to repeat the question. They did. Quite earnestly, I said I would be a Granny Smith apple, since I was a little tart, but once baked into a pie with other apples, I was delicious. It was a group interview over the phone. They murmured that it was a good answer and thanked me for my time. I did not get the job. I don't know if it's the same elsewhere, but here in the UK, volunteering to others that you are a little tart is not the best answer. Well, maybe some jobs. Can you give me some advice about my turtle? I was interviewing to help maintain a database. It had nothing to do with turtles. He was trying to determine if you had experience with shell. This one was sort of my fault, but I was being interviewed and the interviewer asked how I would handle termination, and I said I would want to know why. She cut me off and apologized and said she meant how would I approach terminating an employee. I asked for the context and she said, imagine you had to fire me. How would that go? I was confused because I wasn't applying for a position superior to her. So I asked what she was being fired for and she, I believe, innocently said, I don't know. I did something really inappropriate to you. With you. I mean, just something inappropriate. It was really weird because neither of us seemed to know how to handle the interview at this point, though I did get the job. If you could be any of the original 150 Pokemon, which one would you choose? I said Ditto, because I could be any of them, but that was a lie. If I could be any Pokemon, I would be Pidgeot. Squirtle pulls out sunglasses. Do you believe in aliens? Obviously a super serious interview for the arcade I worked at in HS. They also asked me to be on their laser tag team in the tourney that night. If it pays well, I'll believe anything you say. Do you have a girlfriend? Why did you break up with your old girlfriend? Double quote. In a technical interview with a few senior employees of the company, when I replied I don't see how this is related to the job I'm applying for, they all got defensive and were like, for example, we are all married. We're asking if you have any social problems. I was seriously confused and still unemployed afterwards. Inappropriate as frick. What is your opinion on wealthy people? I was 22, fresh out of college, and my first interview was working at a private, small bank. I wasn't expecting that question. I would like to be one. You've got a broad set of shoulders on you. You ever do any modeling or wrestling? Hey, thanks for your time. I don't think this would be a good fit for me. Your shoulders say otherwise. So, I see that you're married. Do you frick around? I was interviewing for a supervisor's position. The job was open because they had just fired a supervisor for having sex with a woman that worked under him and they were sued. Man, you'd think a company that just got sued would be more careful of interview questions that could get them sued. Why did you say good morning when you know perfectly well it's afternoon? Can you provide proof that you are not 100 snakes inside of a hollowed out man? No, I cannot. I hope that does not disqualify us, me from getting the job. Not me, but a friend was applying for a Christmas temp job and the last question was, is Die Hard a Christmas movie? Her reply was, number, it's a Christmas classic. She got the job obviously. Christmas is a Die Hard holiday. I was asked, can you stay a few minutes and help me move some furniture? It was for an IT job at an engineering firm. Years later I was told that he was both trying to figure out whether I was a no, that's not what I am being hired for kinda guy, or a sure, I'll do whatever needs doing kinda guy. Also, he did have a couple of desks that he needed help moving. I did stay and help, and I did get the job. I was asked a question regarding my GPA during college. You finished with a 3.2, but had failed a bunch of classes your first year and a half. What the frick was up with that? I was poor in the dorms and couldn't afford my books or Pearson Online Study Questions portal code. They thought it was a suitable answer. Got offered the job. I've never had any employer check my university records, ever. Never heard of anyone doing it either. I was once asked in an interview, "Do you look at your crap after you wipe?" which they asked me to see if I would lie or not. Apparently it is a natural instinct that nearly everyone does, which, back in our caveman days, used to be a way to see if you were getting sick or not via the color of your steaming dung. I laughed and said yes. Not a question, but when I tried to get a job that would involve a fair amount of driving, I half jokingly wrote down driver's license under work experience. My interviewer took one look at the application and said, "Valid driver's license. Good. You're already ahead of the other guy." I once applied for a job that didn't say anything about a need to drive. They asked if my driving record was clean and I don't have a license that would allow me to drive alone, so I said, "So clean it's like I don't even have one." I didn't get a call back. How do you think you did? Freaking nailed it. See you Monday. Walks out. I was being interviewed by a young guy and two older ladies. The guy just kind of stared at me the entire interview while the women asked all of the questions. After they were done questioning me, one of them asked him if he had any questions for me, and before she could finish the statement he blurted out, "Are your boobs real? They look really good." I was in shock. The woman in charge asked me to please wait outside. And after a minute both ladies met me in the hallway and offered me the position I interviewed for at $2 an hour, more than what the position tops out at. I'm still here 3.5 years later, and I've never seen that guy since the interview. It's a tie. At two different interviews. 1. If you were a shoe, what would you be and why? 2. If you were a food, what would you be and why? The first interview was for a job at my college and the second was for a catering job at a different college. Not me, but my husband was asked who he voted for and his personal feelings on his daughter's ability to, one day, she was only like, 7 months old at the time, get birth control without his permission. He told the guy that his personal opinions on such things didn't seem relevant to an accounting position. He didn't get offered the job. Sounds like a blessing. It was for a tech job at a small company when I was young. Google had just become trendy and cool not long before. It was something like, "How many windows are in New York?" I asked if they were serious, and they said yes. It was an exercise to see how I'd work out the problem and they wanted me to answer. So I went with it, cause I wanted to the job, spoke through my reasoning. Then the guy smiles like a jackass and says, "Yeah, really, the answer is if I needed to know I'd just Google it." It was such a dong move and I was such a cocky little crap that I just walked out. Not me, but wife was asked if she knew how to bake. This was for an accounting job. Apparently the office is pretty big on treat days, so they wanted to know if she'd bring stuff. They were trying to figure out if she would cook the books on the down low. Treat days are when everyone gets their embezzlement money. ? How old do you think I am? I don't know. 40? You have the job. I'm 60. Whoa. Old enough to repaint, but young enough to sell. I actually used that once and it made them laugh. After what did you just say? You're from Russia. You're not a spy, are you? This was for an associate attorney position. It wasn't for me. This isn't the position you are interviewing for. What is it you'd rather be doing? Didn't see that one coming. Your job. In an interview for a tech support position at a software company, they asked me, "Okay, imagine that you're a quality assurance person for a toaster company. How would you test the toaster out to see if you could make it fail?" And I went through every iteration I could think of that would break the toaster. Stick non-bread food items into it, operate it upside down, stuff like that. There was clearly a specific correct answer they were looking for, and after like 10 minutes we just had to move on. I did not get the job. And I will never know what specific thing it was they were looking for with that question. In an interview for software testing, they wanted the answer to include taking it apart and testing the components separately from the whole. One interview in particular stands out in my mind. I hadn't even applied for the job. They found me on LinkedIn, and since I was looking I figured, what the heck? The guy interviewing me came with a list of questions, which is pretty normal. But the questions he asked were pretty weird. One was, if you could have any superpower, what would it be and why? My answer was to fly, because it would be fun and super easy to travel. He liked that answer. Then he asked me to rate things on a scale of 1-10. One was, how much do you value honesty? So I said 9, since I'm an honest person and value honesty in others. He liked that answer. A few questions later he said, how much do you value getting things done on time? I said 7, because you can't always anticipate how long things can take to be resolved and sometimes there are complications. He asked me, so you don't value getting things done on time then? And I said no, it's not that, but I told you earlier that I value honesty more. He really liked that answer. Anyway, they ended up offering me the job and I turned them down. So they called me back with a better offer and I still said no. At this point the nice HR lady asked me why I was turning them down, so I told her, I never even applied for this job. You called me to set up the interview, and the interview I had with your company was one of the weirdest I've ever had, so I don't think it would be a good fit. If I gave you a tiny elephant right now, what would you do with it? Interviewing for a job at a nursing home. What makes you the best candidate? Don't know. I haven't met the other candidates. I got the job. I was being interviewed for an IT help desk job at a bank a number of years ago and was asked why are manhole covers round. I was later told after answering wrong that it was to see if the person would say I don't know, correct answer, or just try and BS their way out of it. The idiots at the Northwestern State University of Louisiana asked me which church I would attend once I took the job. For those that don't know, that is an illegal question, and you should nope the frick out if an employer tries to get into your religious business during a job interview. Louisiana doesn't give a crap about that federal law. I had an interview a few years ago at a video rental chain called Family Video. They mainly questioned me about my family and upbringing. My parents are divorced. I was raised by a single mother and I don't have a relationship with my dad. This was really awkward to explain to the manager, who clearly wasn't happy with my broken family and upbringing. I didn't get the job. Was just a young man looking for a job between college semesters. Got an interview at a Texas Roadhouse and the manager goes through the usual questions. Who I am, work history, why work here, and finally gets to his last question. If you could be any animal, what would you be? I definitely wasn't expecting such a question, but it was a fun one I thought. Apparently the answer, poison dart frog, was not what he was looking for. They joked about whether or not they would ask me a question throughout the interview. They didn't for most of it, but by the end, I just had to know what the question was. I had to defend not liking Ready Player One. As part of checking that I'm not a psycho on social media, they came across my Goodreads review summing up why I didn't like the book. One of the interviewers loved it. I'm pretty sure I ended up not getting the job because I got a little too focused on the discussion about the book with that interviewer and the other interviewer wasn't interested. You have been visited by the romantic doggo. Comment love is magic so you never fall in the friend zone. If you are new to the channel, you can subscribe. I publish new videos every day. Until then, check another video, or don't. Either way, have a great day, you magnificent people.